The Honourable Member for Elmwood.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. My question is to the Premier. The sale of MTS to Bell will mean Manitobans will have only three choices for cell service. The experience in other provinces is that we could see rates double. Why won't this government stand up for Manitobans and oppose the sale?
That's right.
The Honourable Minister of Finance.
I thank the member for the question. As I mentioned, this is about focusing on economic development. It's about respectful partnerships with partners in Manitoba. And I would suggest to those members that for too long, their approach has been one of isolation. Their history is not being able to cooperate with partners, not with the federal government, not with the private sector, not with each other on their own benches. We are a government that has made a fundamental pledge to build partnership. That commitment is made in the mandate letters that were revealed today, mandate letters that were never received when this party was in power. We're excited about the opportunities. We're excited about the partnerships that we're growing in Manitoba. We couldn't be more pleased for today's announcement.
The Honourable Member for Elmwood.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. And my question to the Premier is that the sale has to receive the approval of the Federal Competition Bureau and the CRTC. Will the province seek intervenor status to stand up for Manitoba consumers and oppose this sale?
The Honourable Minister of Finance.
Madam Speaker, thank you for the question. I can assure members that we have, from the very outset on this issue, been involved, been speaking to the partners. We've been getting those assurances that this will be a net benefit to Manitobans. I can assure the members that by virtue of the fact that this organization is large, Manitobans are going to reap benefits. They're going to have access to those better technologies. They're going to have access to that better internet access. They're going to have access to better data. These are things that are significant for Manitoba. These are changes that were left undone. They are changes that we will get done with willing and earnest partners.
The Honourable Member for Elmwood on a final supplementary.
Well, thank you, Madam Speaker. My question also to the Premier is the real reason that this government won't oppose the sale because of the close ties between the PCs and the board of MTS?
Right. Yep.
The fact that key Tory insiders made millions from the privatization of MTS and stand to make millions more from the sale to Bell.
The Honourable Minister of Finance.
Thank you, Madam Speaker, and I thank the member for his question. I would remind the members of the opposition that the Western Canada headquarters will continue to be here in the province. We will continue to have these good jobs in Manitoba. But members should understand that this is a major U.S.-Canada trade route on Highway 75 that has been under service with these dead zones along that major corridor. They need to understand that today's announcement is about growing business. They need to understand that they could have undertaken such an initiative. They chose not to. We will get it done with willing and earnest partners who are focused on helping Manitoba grow the economy. We'll get that job done.